Hi. In this video, we will cover a basic workflow, one that will receive an email and send its contents to a SharePoint list. Let's imagine that we are receiving email messages with purchase orders from our clients. This information needs to be downloaded from the mail server and stored in a SharePoint list. This task cannot be done using the default set of activities available in SharePoint Online. So we will create this workflow using custom actions added by HarePoint Workflow Extensions for Office 365 and illustrate how this solution can help you automate any business process in SharePoint. Side note, the same workflow can be created in the on-premise environment using another solution, HarePoint Workflow Extensions for SharePoint. As you can see, there is already one test email waiting to be processed. We're going to use a SharePoint list called Incoming Orders to hold the data from orders received. This includes the order's title, sender, attachment, and any other value. Let's start by opening SharePoint Designer and creating a new site workflow. We can find various actions added by HarePoint Workflow Extensions in separate categories here. Right now, we are planning to work with emails. So we'll go to the email group and add the Receive Email action to our workflow. Let's configure the action to work with IMAP. We are adding the server address and selecting MIME format for the messages, as we will need the attachments later. Our MIME body will be stored in a variable called Output Body. To receive emails, the workflow will need to connect to the email server and authorize. For that, we will use a special action from the workflow group, Set Authentication. Let's specify the authorization method, email server. We will use an encrypted token to authorize on the email server. This choice is preferable since plain text for the login and password are not really secure. The token can be generated in the security settings of the HarePoint Workflow Extensions app. Here we encrypt the login and password for the email account. Then we copy the token and paste it into our workflow action. For the workflow to process incoming emails, we need to check whether we have received any new email or not. This can be done using a special condition, if any value equals value. Here, we will specify that the email sender variable cannot be empty. The next step is to create a new list item. The corresponding action can be found in the Lists group. The list item can hold various data. In this example, we will store the email subject in the title column and sender in the sender column. Next, we will point to the location of the list that will hold the data from incoming emails. After that, we need to configure the workflow to save the attached files from incoming email. The email group has an action for that called Save Email Attachments to List Item. Additionally, we can use a file mask to specify which file types should be saved. Let's select PDF and Word document types. The workflow receives files themselves from the variable output body, which already contains the message's MIME body. After that, the workflow needs to save the files to our list. For that, we need a new variable, item URL. Now we just need to finish the workflow. And that's it. Let's publish our new workflow to a SharePoint website and launch the site workflow through the site contents page. In a moment, we see that the workflow has been successfully executed. Logs show us all the steps that were completed. Authentication successful, email downloaded, list item created, and attachments saved to that list. As a result, our SharePoint list now has a new item with data from the incoming email. Note that the email stored on the server is now marked as red. That was a basic example of what can be achieved with the help of additional actions provided by HarePoint Workflow Solutions, which can help you create complex and flexible workflows without coding or in-depth configuration. Feel free to download a 30-day trial of the product or contact us for a personal demo session.